Thinklikeahorse people, this was sent to me. It's called Zip's First Ride, in case I forget to put it in the video. I'm just going to point out a couple things that, I mean, it went okay. There's a couple things that I think they could have done a little bit better. But for the most part, the horse ain't bucking and ain't getting stressful, and they've obviously done some things right. So let me start this here, and then I'll talk while they're running around. Okay, so you notice when she's lunging this horse, she's not chasing it or being crazy. She's basically just walking and putting a little pressure. Now, you'll notice this gate back here. I'm going to move back here a little bit that this horse comes around. Anytime you have a round pin like this, I've seen a lot of horses hurt like this. If somebody comes up there and gets too much pressure, or a horse starts filling his oats and running real fast, it's very easy for his knee or leg to hit one of these poles, or to get caught, or to slip off the rocks and go underneath here, right at this pole, and they can twist an ankle very easy. If you're going to have a round pin like this, I would put wood probably from here down. And that gives, and then it does a couple things. If you just put some plywood here from here down, if you put sand or anything in there, it doesn't wear a path and push all your dirt outside the round pin, because that wood right there will help stop the dirt from coming out. It will also, as they push the dirt on it, it makes a little ramp right there. So when a horse gets close or gets close aside, if he hits that plywood, his foot will come straight down and slide down. That way you kind of cover up the poles, you cover up this gapping, and it's a little bit safer for the horse. So that's just a little round pin tip if you're building a round pin or you're working in one and you want to improve it. You know, for the bottom foot or so, put some solid wood. So, now the other thing right here is this gate. Always a bad thing. Again, same thing. A horse can go through there, get his foot caught as he's running around, slip underneath it, get caught, tripped. But let's take a look at this lady lunging this horse here. They got a rope halter. There's no bit. The mane's braided. Not a fan of that. If the horse does start bucking or shake his head, it can sting it and hurt. He may panic. Having a loose, free mane is better probably. She's dragging a whip. She's not chasing him. She's not stressing him out. That's good. So the horse is sniffing. A lot of horses do that when they got something on their back. He doesn't seem too concerned. He's not bucking. She just backed up and the horse came in. Made a really good draw there. The horse stopped. So she's establishing some good ground manners on the ground. So the horse knows how to move off pressure when somebody's on the ground. She did what's called an inside turn. She backed away. The horse turned inside to face her. Then she moved to the other drive line and got the horse to go the other way. She did it very smooth, without a lot of pressure, without using a whip, without scaring a horse. So far all this is pretty good. I'm going to go back here just a second and stop this while I'm talking. Anytime you got a new horse, you want to make sure and secure anything that can scare him. I said I didn't like the mane. I also don't like this rope on this rope halter hanging here. If the horse gets in a spook or moves real quick, that's going to slap him. That may increase the spook or put him into a bucking. So I don't like that rope hanging there. So that should be tucked down and secured. Otherwise, what else are we doing here? So now she's got a change in gates. That's good. Again, she's being pretty calm. Notice the horse is kind of facing the gate with his hips to her. That's because the ground has been worn out and there's a little path there. And when you get round pins like that, if you don't keep that area where the horses are at level or working, it starts getting this outside slant and the horse has to compensate and they don't run what I call true and square. So he's running with his butt canted out a little bit. Not a big deal, just things to be concerned with or aware of. Again, she stops him, he faces her, comes in to relieve pressure, gets on a block here. She's got rope reins tied to a rope halter like that. No bit, no pain, good deal. She's doing a little sacking out right there, making sure the saddle's tight and making sure the horse is comfortable. With her climbing up, she got down, climbed up, shook the saddle, She's doing a lot of good things here. Did you see that kick there? You want to be very aware of that when a horse is, when you're starting a horse or doing his feet or doing anything. If a horse is worried about flies or something's bugging him, you want to fly spray and get rid of that distractor. I want this horse paying attention to me, not paying attention to a fly biting him, and then all of a sudden he gets spooked because I do something. He was paying attention to the fly. So when I see a horse kicking or doing something like that, he's uncomfortable, I'm going to find out what that is. Check the cinch, make sure there's nothing sticking him, and things like that. That was a very slight little thing most people would miss, but his tail's getting a little active, and it kicks. So he's frustrated, and he's showing that frustration. So she climbs up, and his head goes up. She's got somebody holding a horse. That's probably good if that person owns a horse. I think she's kind of like riding the horse first time. I think she kind of blew it here. She should have stopped. The horse backed away. She stayed on there and kind of jumped on him. So now she's pretty much committed. She's got to get on him, even if it goes bad right now. She probably should just let him get back, but I think her foot kind of got caught in a stirrup and she couldn't abandon it. So she goes, screw it. That was my best move. I don't think that's bad or some critical error and she's a dummy. I'm just saying it would have probably been better had she abandoned that and moved the stool back, because the horse backed away from something instead of trying to just jump on him and rush it. The horse controlled her mount right there. She didn't control it. Because the horse backed away when she was going to get down. So he moved forward. She stopped him. Probably pulled a little too much. And now the horse kind of pulled her away from that and controlled her mount and picked the time. So she gets on. She's adjusting her pants. Her pants are a little tight if she has to pull them up when she gets on. She's leaning around. Because she has somebody down here on the bottom, I've seen a lot of people start horses, and they'll actually have a lead rope, and they'll actually lead the horse. And that's a good way to get a horse used to a rider. They got somebody on the ground, and all you do is you have a person sit up there while you're leading him, and you walk him in a circle, you back him up, you turn him left or right, and a person just rides, doesn't give him any commands. That's a good way to start. We got a dog coming out, little distractor. Could that be controlled? I would have probably controlled that, but the dog seems pretty chill. Okay, so here's where I got a problem. My biggest problem out of this whole starting is this horse doesn't know forward movement. You don't want a horse standing still when you're starting a horse. You want a horse to move, and he's got to know forward movement. And you teach a horse forward movement with sound, verbal commands, and physical. So the horse should know that when I click and say walk, he moves forward. The reason why the horse doesn't know that is when she was round pinning him, she never said anything. She never associated, when I want you to go forward, move off, I'm going to say walk, and I'm going to put pressure, and you're going to walk. And when I want you to trot, I'm going to click and say trot, and then you're going to associate, I got to pick up my speed when I hear trot. So you teach the horse on the ground the verbal commands, so when you get on him, you have a place to start, so the horse knows when you give him a verbal, he's heard it before, and he knows what he's supposed to do. And then you combine it with a squeeze of the legs, not kicking. She's kicking a little more than I would want to. And she's doing okay. The horse is backing up, and she's letting it. Is that a good thing or a bad thing? I mean, she's kind of committed. She's already blown it because she hadn't taught it forward movement. The horse doesn't know it's supposed to go forward with her. She's not saying walk. She's not clicking. She's giving any clues whatsoever, except she's squeezing and kicking her feet, and the horse is backing up. So that's the biggest part. I think she dropped the ball here. She didn't teach him forward movement with verbal commands, so she could reinforce that with verbal when she got on. So I'll let you hear what she's going through here while she's getting on here. Kicking, moving her hips. Clicking, moving her hips. The horse going backwards. I don't like she's patting the horse. You don't pat a horse. And a horse is going backwards.
Not backwards.
So now this girl's trying to help, which I don't know if that's a good thing or not. That could put extra stress on a horse. He gave a good flex. She's doing the legs, the ribs, the kick, and the horse, now she's slapping him. Horse going backwards.
You know what a lot of them do, and I allow it.
Yeah.
That's a clue. She says a lot of them do. You know what? That's a clue. If your horses are going backwards when you get on them, you haven't done the proper groundwork to prepare them what forward movement is. You haven't gotten next to them and touched their side of their rib and said walk and click or do something so they know to go forward when something touches the side of their rib and they walk forward. You failed to set the horse up for success. And she says a lot of the horses do it, which tells me she's not getting it. She's letting the horse decide the first ride which way to go. And that may work out and it may not. But I personally don't like, if I get on a horse, he needs to know how to move forward, move in a circle. I want to keep him going where he's going forward in a circle. I don't want him backing up into a fence, getting spooked, not seeing where he's going. Horse backs up when he's insecure. He's trying to relieve pressure either from her or the reins, and since she's not pulling on the reins, it's her. So he's trying to move away from her. And horses back away when they're trying to relieve that pressure sometime. So that's kind of an issue I got.
He went nothing but backwards the first time.
So now she's kind of pulling on the reins and kind of teaching him how to go backwards. I'm okay with that. If he's going to go backward, I might as well associate it to me giving a little pressure on the reins and tucking his head and not fight it. So she's doing good there. Active tail and kicking. Those are signs. He doesn't like her kicking in the ribs. Why are you kicking me? I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I'm frustrated. What do you want me to do? If a horse doesn't know what you want him to do, then you failed. So the horse is giving a lot of signs, the ears back, the tail flicking, the leg up, and he's backing up when she's telling him to go forward. We call that a clue. And the clue is, she didn't prepare him on how to go forward. The horse is confused. When you get on a new horse for the first time and he's confused, that's not a good thing. You want the horse to know what to expect. The horse should know what's going to happen before it happens. And if he doesn't, you're kind of setting him up to fail. So anyway, that's Zip's first ride using an Unfair Use Act. So, you know, I don't want to hear any crying and complaining. I'm picking on her and being mean, whatever. If you want to go watch the whole video, go to the link and we'll end that there.